Hello, gorgeous friends. Welcome back to, well, my channel. And today I'm going to be doing an anti-haul, and this is in collaboration with Liv from Liv Loves Her Makeup. I'm going to link her channel down below. And if her video is already up, I'm going to link it in a card somewhere in the screen. Now, Liv and I have decided that we're going to do this anti-haul together. But I wanted to put a little bit of a twist to it, wherein I not only tell you what I'm not gonna buy, but I'll also tell you some of the things that I think would be worth my money and why. So instead of just telling you, don't buy this shit, I'm also gonna tell you, maybe you should look into this. Okay, and I'll tell you my reasons why. I guess I'll start off with the things that I am not going to buy. And I'm gonna try to insert the pictures here because I've created a collection in my Instagram of my makeup do's and don'ts, or so the ones that I will buy and the ones that I won't. The first thing that I'm not gonna buy is this new collection that's coming out from Benefit, which is a collaboration with 5 YouTubers. There's Manny MUA733, there's Jeffree Star, there's Laura Lee, there's I Love Sarah Yee, and Nicole Guerrero. Of those 5, YouTubers, I've never watched Sarah Yee or I Love Sarah Yee. I only like Nicole Guerrero. The other 3, I am not a fan of. I will not be buying that collection for the mere reason that I do not want to be lining the pockets of Jeffree Star or Manny MUA. Laura Lee, I am indifferent to. I don't really watch her. I find her a little bit over the top and annoying. I know a lot of people love her. It's just way too much for me. So no, I won't be buying that. They call it the Beauty Stowaways, which essentially are already existing products in their line. They're just putting it into a collection and putting the faces of those YouTubers on there. No, if I wanted anything from that box, I'm just going to buy them individually. And that's it. The next thing that I'm not going to be buying is this Quill and Ink by Storybook Cosmetics. Don't know if you can see that, but that's what it looks like. Yeah. So I'm not going to be buying that because I just don't see the reason why it exists. It's supposed to be an eyeliner. And I'm just not into those things. I would rather stick to my Maybelline Hyper Sharp liner that I use and love and is very readily available here in drugstores in Australia. I also am enjoying the tattoo liner. Oh, and just so you guys know, I don't need any more eyeliners, whether it's pencil or pen form, because I've got a whole bunch of them right here. And yeah, no thanks. This is just a gimmicky packaging. I don't even know what the quality is of the actual ink inside. And it's freaking $39. The Kat Von D tattoo liner is $20, and I already find that very, very expensive. You want me to pay $39 for an eyeliner? You've got to be kidding me. No fucking way. Okay, what else? Here I've got the... Oh, here. This is the... I'll show you the one that I was talking about in with Benefits. This one here. Okay, I'm not buying that. No. Okay. So, and then I'm also not buying this contour and highlight kit with brush from the KKW Beauty collection, and for the very same reason that I'm not going to line the pockets of Kim Kardashian. No thank you. I've seen a lot of reviews of her contour kits, the one that come in the stick form, and there's very mixed reviews about it. Some people love it, some people hate it. The product itself, from what I understand, is not a bad product, but the amount of product that you get for the price that you pay is ridiculous. Now, I have seen Beauty News actually destroy the kit, the stick contour kit, and they're saying that there's actually more product in there that you can use, but it's like at the nib, you can't get it out of the container, so it's pretty much useless anyway. And it breaks off quite easily because they did the stupid thing of making the base narrower, which makes no sense. I mean, why would you do that? So it tends to break off easily, and for something that will cost you $60 a kit, no way am I paying that. And I'm assuming that this one is going to be quite expensive as well. It says it's going to come out on August 22nd. No thanks. I have my, I actually prefer powder kits. So this might be something, because I think these are powder contours. But I do like my Lorac Pro Contour Palette. I actually even love my e.l.f. Contour Palette. And this is, what is this, $6? Let me look at that. That was my phone. I mean, look at that. Look at that. And look at this. Aren't they similar? Yeah. $6 versus how much is this going to be? No way. So that's number three. Here, what else? Oh, Tarte is coming out with another one of their big blush book. I think this is number three. You can see that there. While this is interesting to me, and I do love Tarte blushes, I've had to give away my ones just because I will never get through them. So I sent it to the Philippines and had my cousins use it, and my sister-in-law. This one is going to be in very bulky packaging, just like the first two ones that came out. Not that I would be traveling with it anyway to begin with, and I believe the last ones were actually ones that you could remove from there, from the container, and put in a Z palette. That might be a solution to people who would like to travel with this, but for me, I do have enough. I can't believe I'm saying this. I have enough blushes that I don't need this. If I was going to buy a blush, I think I would go for that. What's that trio that Becca came out with? I am looking into that, but I don't know if I'm going to buy it just because I do have a lot of blushes already, and I only got two cheeks, and I'm not going to be applying two different shades on each cheek anyway, so I don't think I'll be buying this. And the last thing that I am not going to be buying is this Moschino and Sephora limited edition collection. Granted, it's really cute. This like sort of like a teddy bear. It's in a gold compact teddy bear looking thingy, and it's got several shades in there. What does this information say? 21 different shades and finishes for $48 in the bear compact mirror. The bear compact mirror is an additional $18. Oh, okay. Well, at $48, I'm not even going to bother to buy that. I've seen a few pictures of this, but I'm not impressed, and I'm not really, I don't know, I just don't see myself owning that. And I just thinking about how I'm going to store this palette is giving me anxiety. So yeah, no, I'm not going to be buying that. I've got, if I look at the colors of the shadows that are in there, I feel like I have all of those shades already. And the ones that I don't, there's probably a reason why I don't own them. It's probably because I don't like them. Okay, so there you go. Those are my anti-haul products. Now, there are a few things that I would like to purchase, and one of them is this Huda Beauty Desert Dusk Palette. It looks gorgeous. I'm still thinking about it because these are quite expensive. The existing one here in Australia is called, I think it's called the Rose Gold Palette. That cost $95 here in Australia. But the shades here in the Desert Dusk Palette, especially the one in the center that looks like a lilac, the one right there, and the sort of the green one at the end here is very intriguing to me. So that's probably why, but I'll wait for this to come into the Australian Sephora and swatch them. I've heard mixed reviews of the rose gold palette, so I'm not gonna be buying this online at all. I'll be trying to get this through the store and see how I feel about it before jumping into purchasing it. Oh, I forgot one thing that I am definitely not gonna be buying, and it is the this is an anti-haul product. This is the Jouer Time collaboration with Jeffree Star. I'm not going to be supporting that racist bigot. Okay. And am I the only one who thinks he kind of looks like Taylor Swift in here? Is it just me? Maybe it's just me. But yeah, I won't be supporting him or this product or anything that he'll come out with. No thanks. Something that I am interested in purchasing, maybe one of the kits in here, is the Pat McGrath Unlimited Edition Collection. Oh, that's cute. Yeah, it's coming out at Sephora US on October 6th, and those are the items in the collection. The one in the center, the eyeshadow palette there, is Calling My Name. So I am interested to see if how that's going to be, and if it's going to be released here in Australia. I'd like to swatch it first. I hear that her products are really good, but also quite expensive. All right, what are the other things that I will be buying? Okay, here's one. This is the Hourglass Cosmetics Holiday 2017 palette. It's an ambient strobe lighting palette. I'm thinking that I might pick that up. I don't own any of their strobe lights, and these look really nice. But I do have quite a bit of highlighters already, so I don't know if I am going to be purchasing this. But this would be something that I could potentially spend my money on, because I do like the formula of Hourglass, and I've heard so many good things about their strobe lighting. Now, the last thing that I will potentially be buying is something from the Stila collection that's going to be coming out for the holidays. I have tried their liquid lipsticks. I'm not a big fan of how it dries on my lips, but those liquid eyeshadows, what are they called? What are they called? I don't know what they're called, but they're like the glitter and glow liquid eyeshadow set. I am thinking that that might be something that I need in my life. It's the one right here. Yeah, this one. I don't own any of them. I don't know how it's gonna work on my super oily lids, but I've heard so many good things about them from people that I trust, so I may be looking at purchasing that. And those, ladies and gentlemen, are my anti-haul or makeup do's and don'ts, the ones that I may potentially spend my money on, not yet 100% sure, and the ones that I am absolutely not wasting a single cent on. So like I said, this is a collaboration with my good friend Liv. If you haven't heard about her, you're probably living under a rock. So I'm going to go ahead and link her channel down below. And like I said, if her video is already up, then it's going to be somewhere linked in the screen. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you all again in the next anti-haul video. Bye!